Hello and welcome to this episode of Makerbox Mondays. In this episode I'm going to look at a filament from Healthfil called Fortis LL White. It's some special filament, but let's have a look after the intro. So this filament is a specialty filament. It's called Fortis LL White. Looking here at the label, the print temperature should be 250 to 265, bed temperature 690 and speed 40 to 60 and cooling 20 to 100%. And other packaging tape may help with bed adhesion. And here they say Fortis Orthopedics 3D filament. I'm not sure how to say that word. The polyfin matrix allows the combination of relative elasticity, elastic memory, and enervation resistance with high wear and laceration threshold. I'm not good with those words. Another key strength is the exceptional lightweight properties. And more information can be found on healthfil.com, and it's made in Italy. But let's look at the prints. My first print had a bed adhesion problem on my PI sheet, so this came off quite easily. So I just turned to PET tape, and it's stuck to the bottom. So this has some glue on it. But here's the first print, and this came out pretty good. There was no issues. It might be too bright here on the screen. Turning the light away, you can see it prints really nice. Absolutely no issues, no stringing to speak of or any issues. So this was coming out pretty cool. I did this stringing test, just a test. There's a tiny amount of stringing, but this is like a retraction test. But this is quite flexible, and play with this and pull on it, and it's quite strong. I can't break or pull those strings off, so it's really tough. Did the maker coin, and that came out pretty good as well. And here you can see the remains of the packaging tape. I have to clean this off, but it's really good. It stuck really good to the packaging tape, so the remains of it just fused with the material. So that gives some idea about the properties or the chemical that's used. But this is really tough. It's quite difficult to break. But print quality is pretty good. Maybe you can see some inconstant. You can see some issues here maybe in the head. But I don't know if it's with the color or the diameter of the filament. Looks like under extrusions at some point. I did the Benzi, and here I had some cooling issues, but other than that it came out pretty nice. No stringing issues, so to speak. So here's just some cooling. I was running the cooling maybe a little bit too low for this print. Maybe that's just my fault. Here I did Mr. Belly, and here it has a cooling issue. Here I was printing basically just too fast for this thin legs to be able to cool down. So this is a test if the filament needs to cool down a little bit more than maybe normal PLA. So the legs were melting, but it recovered, and the body portion printed pretty nice. And here again the head melted a little bit. This is an indicator that I need to slow down the prints for this type of print, where it's just small thin legs. But I was quite happy to try this filament. It's I don't know the chemical compound used for this filament, but it's an engineering filament for sure. and you need a maybe a good environment as well to print this, or a good settings. It's difficult to tune in a filament with the samples, so this is like the speed settings, something that you need to test quite a bit before you get the best settings, because you have a small sample, you can't get everything right. But I think that was not fault of the filament, just my settings. But this will be it for this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.